Thinking about heading outdoors, fellas. We got some neighbors. They're super cool. They like to go camping. And some seem to want to do a camp like a Walt Whitman, crust of bread, jar of water, spear.
Forage,
okay? Someone's going to go noodling for catfish. Someone's going to be digging for morel mushrooms. And then others are like, if I don't have a 42-inch LED that streams Hulu, I'm heading my ass back to the rental car and getting back to civilization. Speaks, you said off air, you've never actually been camping.
No, never been camping. Recently I was thinking about not doing it, but yeah. I was wondering, as I often do, I was thinking about myself. And
we have that in common.
Right,
we
right.
We both think of you.
And I was wondering what it would be like to stay in a tent. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if it was completely sealed, but then, you think of a bear breaking in, and then the wild animal also.
Oh yeah,
breaking.
That tent is all. Yeah. It's just a candy wrapper.
Yeah,
you're the Snickers inside. It's right. Gonna peel that thing back pretty quick to get to the right. Soft meat.
Yeah, so I don't think I would be able to do it. And then you're talking about a cabin or
and
something?
Some other people. Marianne asked a good question.
Seems like it's cheating.
You have a cabin.
Yeah,
like you know. Original 13 colonies, Roanoke cabin, which is just logs on logs on dirt.
You see the outside through the...
Yeah. You got to put mud in between to seal it up. Maybe there's a small hearth. All right. Now, that's still kind of roughing it, but you're out of the elements.
Well, what about going to the bathroom?
Well, then you have some of the cabins that I have stayed in is a fancy boy with silken hands. Oh, I mean, you're talking full kitchen. We're talking sat phone, Wi-Fi. We got like carpet in there. There was one of them I rented one year for the fellas that had a hot tub in the house. Went into
we're
debt
camping.
Of it. Guys, we're like the settlers. Someone get me another Pinot Grigio.
Paul Engels.
God, I feel like one of the original members of the Santa Maria. And Marianne, what say you? If you were to, do you camp? Are you a camper? Are you in the family?
I've been once.
Yeah.
With a boyfriend, New York City. We went to Vermont. Mm-hmm. And this is before I was married, not my boyfriend. Oh. And it was so cold. Mm-hmm. He was.
What time of year?
October. It was stupid. And he was one of those guys really roughing it, you know, and he pulled over on the highway and was like, this is land that you're allowed to camp on. And we just went into the woods and I'm like, this does not feel right.
Whoa, so he just went. Oh,
yeah.
That's wild. So he didn't even go to a campground.
No,
he's like,
this is technical land. Like, he's one of those guys.
This is
like,
public land.
Yeah, that we're allowed. And I'm like, but and I said, I'm cold. And he said, what part of you is cold? And I'm like, all of it.
My body.
Yeah. And I said, I got a credit card and we're going to get a hotel. And I was broke at the time.
So you didn't. He wanted to, but instead you went up the street to the Holiday Inn.
I think we did. I think I was like, it's so cold. I just wasn't prepared. I didn't have the right stuff.
Yeah, I was saying early on yesterday that I tried to do his style of camping once with a couple of friends my early 20s in Shenandoah Valley.
Ooh.
And Shenandoah Valley, that's pretty. Actual campground. There's rangers, there's paths and stuff like that. But when I tell you, it's so hard in regards to what we didn't pack.
Yeah.
I'm wearing like dress shoes out there. One of us had pleated khakis. One guy, we're like, all right, what's the food? We just had like four Lunchables, a lot of Twizzlers, one Dr. Thunder.
You need so many supplies to properly camp.
None of it. The tent we have that our one friend swore, oh, this thing can sleep 4 to 5 people. It was a plastic prison cell with three dudes side by side, farting it up, shivering. It was cold as hell. Didn't get any sleep.
It's easy to be uncomfortable when you camp.
Yeah.
And you have to just do so much prep work to do it the right way. It's just not worth it.
But there's like a part of me, you know, as a man, part of me wants to like, I wonder how I'd do if I was just left to my own devices. You are watching the survival shows, the Man vs. Wild,
yeah.
Survivor Man.
Yeah.
I've been left in the middle of the great forest of northern Montana.
With a camera crew.
I've got a whole camera crew and plenty of shelter. But all I've got is this knife and this lighter. Yeah. And for the next week, I'm going to see what I can do. And you watch those going, oh, yeah, I would have done that. That's how I would have made that lean-to.
I just can't. Yeah.
I think I'm done if you do it.
Yeah. I feel like I need to study to learn what I'm supposed to eat and not, and the supplies from REI are gonna be like a summer home in and of itself, the cost.
Yeah.
So I just, it's like running a marathon. I'm like, someday maybe.
One day when I get myself towards it, like I'm already about to have a cardiac arrest during a 5K, much less a marathon.
There's just things in the distant future that I'm like, I don't know, not yet.
410-338-1098. Angela, sweet Angela, we hope the homestead has gotten better since the tornadoes. Her neighborhood took it on the chin. Never been camping, but I feel like I'd want the naked and afraid experience without the nakedness. Okay, so you just want to be afraid. You just want to be out in the woods, terrified.
I mean, take a walk
bears.
At night in the woods. Yeah. You'll get your fix.
Go to Patterson Park. It'll scratch that itch right around 1 a.m. when a guy comes shambling up to you wearing nothing.
You camping?
But, yeah, what are you doing here? Let me camp in you. James, my parents are RVers. They go to different places all the time. At the end of the month, my son and I are going to be going with them to Frontier Town in Berlin. Most of the time, we sit outside lounging, hike, swimming, fire. They got a golf cart. Okay, so that's pure comfort. That's a drivable home.
Uh-huh.
Steven, I prefer camping, but I have a child, which means making sure we need some specific amenity.
My God.
That's another thing, too. If me and this crew go,
kidding me?
There's going to be 7 kids.
No. I don't know. I don't know how people do it. It just seems like, I mean, I went to Disney and it was a lot of work. I felt like going to Disney was camping because you're out on the pavement all day. Your backpack's full of snacks and water and whatever, but you're spending way more money. But it's just the prep work involved is just so daunting. Is it worth it? Are the views in the morning and having slept in fresh air worth the amount of
yes, is that
is it
is that orange sky as the sun bathes it in his glow, crusting over the mountains, worth the 300 bites you got in the middle of the night? Your back is jacked up. The firewood is now wet. You're not getting anything to eat.
Porta potties, I'm assuming. Camping.
Dump it in a hole.
Yeah.
Could you?
I don't
you
know
make
if
bathroom
it's gonna
in a hole.
Me?
Like, I mean, shovel, spade.
Oh.
The granola got to me.
Yeah.
Time to back one out.
Yeah. I have, yeah.
I've right, been on hikes. Coming up on the other side of sports, we're going to find out about Marianne.
It's my preferred way.
Going brown town somewhere in the outback, and then we want to talk to you, 410-338-1098. The camping versus the glamping. What's the situation? How hard do you rough it where you're identifying local flora, fauna that you can eat spearfishing? Or do you need all the amenities of a big downtown Baltimore Inner Harbor Marriott in your cabin? 410-338-1098.
Yeah, manly man.
If you headed out into the wilderness to do some camping, are you laying down on a bed made of sticks, rocks, an animal's hide you just wrangled to the ground, did jiu-jitsu on a mountain lion, peeled its fur off, eating berries you foraged, catfish you dove upon in the water? Or are you more like my fancy ass, because I get UTIs easy, and you need a cabin, you need the RV, you need to have some sort of air conditioning's a big one. That might be the number one. Because even in a cabin, the kind you were talking about, Marianne, joining us this morning, where there's no amenities, but it's still a structure, it still gets a little funky in there. The air is still, it's hot, it's muggy, you're damp. You're, you know, depending on the time of year, or you're shivering, you're cold. If you go into like an RV, you go to a cabin, you turn on the heat, space heater.
I don't call that camping.
Fans. That's why they came up with glamping. Glamour camping. And
air mattress.
You, yes, exactly.
A tapestry on the wall of the tent.
Something, yes.
Decor.
Five streaming services.
Right.
Well-stocked fridge.
Maybe a little blender.
Yeah, if you are anywhere near a bidet,
right.
You're not camping. Apollo says camp for a few nights and then finish with the glamp. It's a good way to end the trip by ending it with a little bit of luxury. Oh, that's pretty cool. Barb.
Yeah, I'm curious about the perks, like we were saying, of camping. Like, why do you love it? You know, like, what is the
closeness to nature
I
bit?
Guess.
Because it's not just camping. Then you got to go do stuff. You got to go hike or fire.
The thing that I'm fixated on is the outdoor bathroom stuff.
Oh yeah.
How, does it involve squatting? Or I've also heard that you can sit on a rope.
Oh.
Why are you not editing that? Right
I,
now?
Describe the sitting.
I've heard that you just sit on a rope,
like tie it between two trees. Taut.
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Yeah, have you heard of that?
No, but I understand making a ledge for yourself.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, yeah.
This is all new. Sit on a rope.
Like a hammock.
But I can't go to the bathroom in public.
I mean, when you go to the bathroom here on the fourth floor, the foundation shakes.
Yes.
Okay, the lights flicker, the generation turns on, Tony Pan screams, hit the deck. Yeah, wow, this is a thing.
It is?
Yes, where some people take not just their, not rope, you could also take a hammock and make it real taut.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, like a...
Hang your butt over the side.
Soap
and
on a rope.
Do your naughty business.
Poop on a rope.
There's a lot of people that will also take a bucket. With a lining.
That's disgusting.
And then, I mean, Josh, there's nothing in this, what I'm about to show you, but a lot of people will do that. Could you?
Oh, with a lining? Yeah, I could probably do that.
And they have a lid, so when you get done making your offal, you can go ahead and put the lid back on, seal it up real nice, carry it with you to your next waterfall destination.
Yeah, I could carry it around.
What did you Google to get, because I Googled pooping on rope. And I'm not getting anything that's
I have a different internet
relevant.
Over here.
You got
much different
Pat
internet.
Sajak's picture.
Yeah. Hey, what's happening? So we ask you 410-338-1098. We got more people. Barb, always love to hear from Barb. We are tent campers. My dad grew up camping. We stick to campgrounds, state parks. I think the thing you told us about your boyfriend kind of made people cock their head a little bit to the right, where a boyfriend tried to go camping with you, Marianne, and just pulled over on the side of the road.
Mm-hmm.
It was like, you see that gigantic field?
Yeah.
Let's head there.
Have at it, yeah.
Like, did he check?
It was the woods.
The forest.
He had a map, and he knew where you technically are allowed to be, and that was what he chose.
Did you see the way Brandon camped growing up?
No.
Brandon, our friend Brandon, the unofficial fourth member of the program, as kids, my dad refused to let us have any amenities or luxuries when we went camping. He would take our shoes and make us wear burlap shorts, and he referred to me as Huck Finn the whole trip. Hell yeah. Jen, show psychologist, I'm a noper. I love hiking, but I better have a legit place to bathe and sleep afterwards. My friend, Jess, she writes, my friends invited me camping in November one time, which was the stupidest idea ever. November.
Yeah.
I wore all the clothes I brought with me, still a frozen popsicle, could not sleep all night long. I can't sleep if I'm cold or
sleeping
if I'm
in
wet.
The cold is supposed to be great for you, but there's a limit. There's like a line where it's no longer refreshing and it's just, you're just awake.
Like when you say, Marianne, you're working in the garden. Posies are coming in nice. Look at the size of those cucumbers.
What, posies?
Posies. Mm-hmm. You ever grow a posy?
No. Ring around the...
You ever a posy? Pocket full of posies? Yeah, flowers? They're beautiful. You ever
grow a posy flower before?
No. Oh, my God.
Only in the nursery, right?
Oh, no. Check out... I bet you've seen a beautiful posy before. Hold on. No, Google, you don't need to know my damn location. I'm looking at flowers. Okay. Here's a...
They're adorable. They're so sweet.
Those are posies.
Okay, I've
those
never
little tiny posies.
Never grown them.
Easy to grow. Set them and forget them.
Okay.
But you come in from a long day of being out in the yard. Can you just go to sleep sticky?
No.
When you feel your stuff sticking to your stuff.
Absolutely not.
Mm-mm.
The best sleep is clean sheets after a shower.
Dry.
We all know this.
Yeah, when I slide around on the sheets,
girl.
Josh's rubber sheets, I can hose off.
Yeah.
Let's go to Rich from Big and Rich, line two. Good morning, Rich. What kind of camper are you?
Hey, we got a travel trailer. It's 31 feet long. It has, we'll sleep 10 if you want to.
Okay.
Got an outside kitchen.
Kind of like
having your house with you.
Okay, so you got the amenities. So, I mean, you're not really roughing it, but you guys are out there. You know, you're kind of getting it done. But I don't think anybody's, struggling to survive, right?
No, we got the dog and the cat with us.
Oh,
we're good.
Adorable.
What kind of dog?
He's a Husky Shepherd mix.
What's his name?
His name is George.
Oh, Jorge.
Josh, you know, I heard about a little dog by the name of Freddy this morning.
Really?
Yeah.
Nope.
Marianne?
Nope.
Frankie.
Frankie. Frank Sinatra.
Screwed it up.
You have a dog?
I just got one for the first time.
Oh, really?
I've never had a dog.
What kind of dog?
Cavapoo.
Oh, a Cavapoo.
Yeah.
Found out about Cavapoos today.
Oh, cool. And you have a cat, right?
Yeah, they don't like each other yet. And he doesn't like Robbie.
Oh, very cute.
He's staring Robbie down a lot. He growls.
Dog. Apparently growls at the dog.
Because the Amish puppy mill abused him. So he doesn't like boys.
Let's head to line three. Line three, who's this?
This is Tommy Zimbazo.
Tommy Zimbazo! Tommy, when does your special come out alongside Eric Woodworth with the Bionic Universal Super Soldiers Incorporated?
Comes out June 12th. You can go to Home of the Bionic Universal Super Soldiers Incorporated or hotbussi.com.
That's B-U-S-S-I.
Correct, because we are not monsters.
Boston.
Marianne, you and I have a mutual friend, Jen. And goes hiking, and she'll hike the Appalachian Trail by herself. And she brought a harmonica with her because she heard that if you see a bear, you play the harmonica and the bear will run away. And it 100% happened. She went out, she saw a bear, whipped it out, started playing some Blues Traveler, and the bear was so panicking that it forgot to eat her, and it ran away.
That's hilarious. So bring out some sort of Appalachian harmonica, like you said, Blues Traveler, the Grizzly.
My fiddle.
So wait a minute. How far out in the Appalachian Trail does this Jen go?
She is so courageous. Jen Gant, she's my concert buddy. We go to shows together here.
Okay.
And yeah, she'll go camping by herself.
Wow.
It is mind-boggling. She's got bees of steel.
That's incredible. And again, Tommy, I believe we're going to even have him up very, very soon. June 12th, hotbussi, B-U-S-S-I.com.
That's great, Tommy.
With a special coming out next week. We're going to blow it up online.